I'm sure you guys have heard the popular tagline, no one can eat just one. But have you wondered why? Why can't we stop eating these spicy, salty chips that tingle our taste buds like nothing else? Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Siddharth Warrior. I'm a neurologist. And today I have come as a guest to the BigBasket YouTube channel to talk about neuroscience and everything that can help us live better. And oh, by the way, there's a giveaway question at the end of the video. So stay tuned for a chance to win exciting vouchers from BigBasket. Flavors are more than just the taste. They are how we crave for food, how we experience food, and how we enjoy food. If I have to give an example from history where flavors were more important than other pressing matters, one particular story comes to mind. The French King Louis XIV had an insatiable appetite for flavor, and his chefs had the job of creating elaborate and delicious foods that would tingle his taste buds. And this passion for flavor actually revolutionized French cuisine back in the day. When we eat, our taste buds from the tongue and the back of the throat pick up 5 primary flavors: sweet, salty, sour, bitter, and umami. These flavors interact in our brain in unique ways, and they decide how we perceive food and how we enjoy food. For instance, sweet flavors signal high energy foods, which our brain associates with survival. And that is why sweet foods like chocolates and desserts give us an instant sense of comfort and pleasure. Similarly, salty foods also activate the brain's pleasure system, and consuming salty foods gives us a feeling of pleasure and satisfaction as well. And this makes salty foods like chips and samosas particularly hard to resist because they give us an instant sense of gratification. Umami, which is a savory flavor found in meats, in soy sauce and cheese, gives us a feeling of fullness and satisfaction, which is why these foods make us feel content after eating. These taste signals initially start on the receptors in the tongue and the throat, and from there they go all the way up to the brain, to the gustatory cortex inside the brain. And there they're processed and analyzed, and that is how you consciously know what it is that you are tasting. But remember that taste is only one piece of the puzzle. Equally important is smell. Our sense of smell is controlled by the olfactory system, and that plays a massive role in how we taste food. If you remember back in the pandemic, many people who got COVID infection lost their sense of smell, and because of that, they also lost their sense of taste. And that's not the only interesting thing about taste. Taste can also bring back memories from our past or even trigger deja vu in some people. This is because flavors are strongly linked to memories and emotion. The hippocampus and the amygdala in the brain are linked to memories and emotion, and the flavor signals that go from the tongue to the gustatory cortex also send signals to these two areas, which is why when we eat certain foods, we remember things. And not just that, these memories can also be triggered by things that we see or even think. For example, if you are someone from Mumbai, and I start talking to you about pav bhaji, or even show you a picture of pav bhaji, your brain will now start recreating those memories of eating pav bhaji, imagining how it would feel if you bite into that buttery pav or that hot bhaji and you could almost taste it. And in fact, your mouth may even start watering. And that is why some foods like a childhood dish can elicit such strong emotions in us, because it brings back positive memories from our past. Flavors also influence our snacking behavior because it triggers reward centers in the brain. Whether it is the salt and crunch in chips, the umami in momos, or the spice in namkeen, these flavors trigger pleasure centers in our brain and keeps us going back for more. There are also some genetic differences between people, which is why we say that some people have a sweet tooth or some people like savory things more. Now you may think that, Doc, all this is well and good, but how do I use this learning in my life? One cool way of making this information useful is by learning how to add flavors to our foods to make it better for ourselves and our children so that they eat nutritious food and enjoy it more. Now, the Indian cuisine is rich with spices, and parents can take advantage of this by adding mild spices like coriander, turmeric, and cumin to make their vegetables and lentils more delicious. And there are also popular spices available in some localities in India which the rest of the country can also use. For example, gunpowder or podi from from Kerala. Bukhnu, which is popular in the state of Uttar Pradesh. Kids can enjoy the flavor of these spices by adding them to the dishes they otherwise would not have liked so much. For example, I remember in my childhood, a simple combination of dahi and rice was made so much more tasty by adding gunpowder and a little bit of papad crumpled on top. These add more flavor and texture to the food and it made my lunch so much better. Another hack is to take advantage of sweetness and how kids enjoy sweet foods. And you can use this by adding vegetables and fruits that have natural sweetness into their daily diet. For example, you can use roast carrots, beetroots, and sweet potatoes and adding a little bit of ghee and cinnamon to bring out their natural sweetness. This makes a great side dish for kids to have. These vegetables are rich in natural nutrients like beta carotene and vitamins, but they're also delicious when their natural sweetness is heightened. So the next time your friends ask you how do you get your children to eat healthy, you know which video to direct them to. Now it's time for the giveaway question. What is the name of a locally popular spice mix in South India? Write your answer in the comment section below and you have a chance to win a voucher from BigBasket. If you found this video useful, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and if you have any questions or you have suggestions for future videos that I should do, let me know. I look forward to seeing you all in the next video. Bye everyone, take care.